This video is going to explain briefly how you can transform your data. If you have decided that you need to transform your data, there could be different reasons for this. A common one is that perhaps your data are not normally distributed, or for some reason you have not been able to meet assumptions of a test that you're trying to do. There are different ways that you can transform your data. First of all, I want to show you a quick trick for superimposing a normal distribution curve on a histogram. This can help you visualize your histogram, which, as you know, is important as well as doing stats tests such as the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. These are useful in letting you know if your data follow a normal distribution or not, but visualizing your data is also really important. So if you want to superimpose a normal curve on your histogram, you go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies, select the variable which you want to look at. Here, why don't we decide on the age of the mother? So here, this is a study about babies that are born and how much they weigh when they're born, and lots of different factors have been taken into account. So if I'm interested in this variable, I'll go to charts. At the moment, nothing is selected, but if I select histogram, it then reveals this option, show normal curve on histogram. Continue and okay. So that was quite straightforward. So now in our output window, it provides us some information about our data. So it's just letting us know all these different categories of the data, the way it's broken it down. So the number of women who were aged 18, the number of women who were aged 19, how many, so one person was 18, and so on. So most people here in this study, four of which were actually 27 years old. It's then displayed this histogram here, which also gives us our mean, standard deviation, and the number of samples, or in this case women, who are included. It's superimposed on a normal distribution curve, which in this case perhaps is showing us things are a little skewed to the left, and we have this rather large bar here for the 20-year-olds. So this could actually make us look at our graph and think, our data are not so normally distributed. Look here, we haven't got a nice high, we haven't got a nice bar, which is what we would want to see. So this isn't really in keeping with our curve. So we may decide that we need to transform our data. And as I say, there are different ways you can do it. Log transforming is quite common, square rooting, or the reciprocal of the data. There is a video available from one of our Stats at Liverpool tutors which gives more details about this. And this video can be found on YouTube. It also can be found within the linear regression online tutorial, which you can find in Canvas and Vital, if we're still using Vital. So, to transform your data, as you might guess, you want to go here to the Transform option. You then want to go to Compute Variable. Once you're in here, it's a little confusing at first, but once you get used to it, actually it's quite easy. So the first thing you want to do is we'll just select all here at the top, and this now reveals a whole set of functions underneath. We are going to go for log transforming our data. This isn't always the way that you'll transform your data. You might need to book an appointment with one of our Stats at Liverpool tutors if you need some support on what the best method would be to transform your data. But let's say that we would like to log transform our data. So here we have the logarithm here, base 10. This is what we're going to go for. So if I select this and then I select this arrow, it moves it here into our numeric expression box. Then instead of this question mark, what we really want is we want the variable that we're interested in. So we're interested in the age of the mother. So we use this arrow to move it along. What we will end up doing is we will end up creating another variable. So another column will appear here in SPSS. So we need to just give our column a name. So I'm just going to say that this is the mother's age logged. But I won't put a space in because sometimes SPSS doesn't like spaces in names. And then I'm just going to press OK. This tells us that a new column has been created. So if we go all the way over here to the right, we can see here are the data that we have now just created. And what you could do, for example, is you could go back to Analyze, back to Descriptive Statistics and Frequencies, and this time let's put in the one that we've just created. It should still remember the settings from last time. Okay. So now what you can see is that our normal distribution curve looks more like a normal distribution curve. You can see that the peak is higher than it was before. Can you see how it's much lower? We had gaps here with our data, and we had this very large bar here. This large bar isn't quite as large as it was, and everything just seems a little bit more normalized. So that's how you can transform your data using SPSS.